Nakakuha ka na ba sa unactivated Windows mo? Well, lucky you! Pinakabago mula sa cdkeyoffer.com. Windows 10 and Windows 11 activation codes. Legit, safe, at pinakamura. Madali lang umorder.
Hanapin ang Windows version na gusto mo. Piliin ang preferred payment method. Wala pang 5 minutes, nagsisigi ka na para sa Windows mo.
Marami na kaming natulungan.
Dati, sudden depressed ako. But now, I found the love of my life.
Dati, aimless and walang purpose ang life ko. But now, I'm a world-class Zumba instructor.
So, web developer ako and content creator for a YouTube channel. And ngayon, ganun pa rin ako pero activated na yung Windows ko.
Kaya ako naghahanap ka ng legit, mura, at original software.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
So for today, we're going to be reviewing another budget-oriented air cooler, and that is the Phantom Spirit 120 SE from Thermalright. I do believe this is the first Thermalright product that we're going to be reviewing, so this is very exciting. But spoiler alert, it is amazing performance you're getting for how cheap this unit is. So for the usual disclaimers, the unit we're going to be reviewing today is actually provided by a customer, not even the brand itself. So the review, all our opinions, and the verdict for this video will be our own. So looking at the Phantom Spirit design, this is the quintessential air cooler for CPUs. You've seen this already if you've been following the PC scene for the past 15 years, and this is as simple as it gets. And basically, that's going to be the whole theme for this review. The Phantom Spirit is a no-nonsense, no-gimmicks, just pure good performance for cooling. So for specs, it's a dual tower, dual fan cooler with 7.6mm heat pipes at 154mm tall. It's equipped with two TLC12B V2 fans at 1,500 maximum RPM. So even the product page for this cooler on their website is as simple as it gets. It's just a spec sheet, minimal marketing, just, you know, the plain images of what you're going to be getting outside of the box. So speaking of, the context of the box are the cooler itself, the two fans, some mounting hardware and screws, as well as the back plates for either the AMD or Intel sockets. It also has a small thermal paste tube and a splitter for the fans. And basically, that's it. I'm mentioning that in the video because compared to the last air coolers that we've been reviewing, you know, the Arctic ones, the Assassin 4 and Assassin 4S from Deepcool, this is sorely lacking in those gimmicky technologies. It doesn't have the fancy shroud that the Deepcool one has, or the very innovative and very sexy mounting mechanism for the Arctic. It doesn't have any of those. For mounting the fans, it still has those wire thingies that you can just snap onto the fins themselves. And for the mounting, it's just four screws and a bracket. That's it. Again, it's very simple. It doesn't come in any of those RGB, although there is a slight design at the front for the Evo version of the Phantom Spirit. But for this SE, for this cheapest one, it's just a block of heatsink and two fans. So for testing the performance, we used a 14600K with a B760M motherboard and DDR4 RAM. So while that isn't the most cutting-edge CPU, that's not the hottest CPU, it's still a 14600K, and we pitted it against the Arctic Freezer 36 and the Deepcool AK620. And here are the results. Using Cinebench R24 test at 30 minutes each, and using Arctic MX6 for the thermal paste, the Phantom Spirit manages to comfortably beat both the Freezer 36 and AK620 at maximum temps and even average temps. It is 3 degrees lower than both competition. And by the way, this is 26 degrees ambient temperature of the room in an open case setup. Also, while we don't have a proper tool to measure the noise levels for the fans, we did notice, however, that even at 100% speed of the fans, the Phantom Spirit is relatively quiet. It would have been great if we had a more powerful CPU so we can play around with noise normalization, with setting a consistent wattage or power draw. But realistically speaking, if you're looking at this price point for the cooler, you also won't be using this for anything more powerful than a 14600K. you know, with all of that mentioned, the 14600K is a very hot CPU, even being a mid-range gaming CPU. And with our test results, the Phantom Spirit comfortably cools that beast of a CPU, even with an unrealistic workload such as Cinebench. So imagine mo ba kung meron ka pang cooler na CPU like a 7800X3D or a lower tier 13th or 14th gen Intel CPU. So what's the catch? Yung price nito naglalaro lang between 2,000 to 2,500, depende sa kung saan store mo siya bibilin. And looking at their website, they do have one official distributor store here in the Philippines. Siyempre hindi ko na i-mention yun kasi store din kami. So yun, hindi naman siya masyadong issue. It's just that with things like that, hindi mo masyadong maaasahan yung warranty nun as well as yung availability niya. Although currently looking at the page, mukhang marami naman silang stock. Another catch is since it's an old design, since it's a simple design, the fan does go over the RAM. So although relatively shorter siya at 154mm, you do have to take into account yung RAM clearance niya. And so far, yun lang yung issue niya. It's very cheap. If hindi ka naman naghahanap ng aesthetics, okay lang siya. And actually, okay lang naman itsura niya. It looks like a CPU cooler. It churns out excellent performance even at CPUs that shouldn't be used with this. And personally, I'm very happy of seeing this trend of budget components, really cheap parts that deliver excellent performance, rivaling even yung mga premium at yung mga mahal components. And Thermalright does it right with the Phantom Spirit air cooler. Highly recommended.